Hi, good morning to one and all. Myself, A. Ramanjaneyalu. Today, I am going to explain how to solve the problem based on elastic constants. In previous session, we derived the relation between Young's modulus, rigidity modulus, and bulk modulus. Okay. I taken one problem based on the elastic constraints. Okay, here the problem given that a mild steel bar has a diameter of 10 millimeters and is 350 mm long. A tensile load of 15 kilonewton is applied longitudinally. Calculate the extension of the bar and change in diameter and change in volume. Here now I am taking one mild steel bar. Okay, it is subjected to a tensile load. That is, tensile load is 15 kilonewton. They given 15 kilonewton. Next, the bar consists of diameter. Diameter of the bar given that 10 millimeters. Next, length of the bar is 350 millimeters. Okay, here applied load is 15 kilonewtons. Convert load 15 kilonewtons into newtons. Next, length of the rod is 350 mm. Next, diameter of the bar is 10 millimeters. Okay. Next, we need to calculate the extension in the bar, change in diameter and change in volume. And the given Young's modulus for the mild steel bar is 2 into 10 power 5 newton per millimeter square. And Poisson's ratio. Poisson's ratio, they given that it is denoted by 1 by m, that equals to 0.25. Okay, by using this we need to calculate change extension in the rod bar means change in length. Next, due to the applied load, what happened, the diameter of the bar is going to decrease, so that the change in diameter we need to calculate similarly, and change in volume, the volume of the body also changed. Okay, we need to calculate these three parameters. Okay, we know by using the relations between ECK what which relation is suitable based on the given requirement. We'll use that formulas. Okay, first I am calculating the change in length. Change in length means we know that from Poisson's ratio, the formula for Poisson's ratio is 1 by m is equals to lateral strain by longitudinal strain. Lateral strain by longitudinal strain. Okay, that equals to lateral strain formula is change in here diameter by original diameter by and change in length by original length. Okay, from this the Poisson's ratio they give in that 0.25. okay, next here in this formula we know change in diameter, we need to calculate change in diameter and change in length, so that they given diameter and length, so that by using this formula we cannot calculate the change in length. We know the formula for from Young's modulus, the given Young's modulus from Young's modulus is equation from Young's modulus equation that is E is equals to stress by strain. Stress means load by area. Here they given load and area by using diameter of the rod we can calculate easily. Next, strain. Strain means change in length by original length. Here from formula change length of the bar they given, so that by using this formula we can calculate easily. First calculate the stress that equals to load by area. Load value is 15 into 10 cube and area of the bar is pi by 4 d square. Diameter of the rod given that 10 square. Okay, by calculating this we will get the stress in the material, that is 190.98 newton per millimeter square. It is the stress produced in the bar due to the applied load. Similarly, by substituting this stress value in the above equation, Young's modulus they given that 2 into 10 power 5 that equals to stress value is 190.98 by strain means change in length by original length. That equals to 190.98 by 2 into 10 power 5. Okay. Therefore, delta L is equals to 190.98 by 2 into 10 power 5. When L it comes into this side or this side, it will get multiplied. Their length of the bar is 350. Okay, by simplifying this equation we will get the value of the change in length in the bar is 0.334 millimeters. Okay, next, now we calculated change in length. Next we need to calculate change in diameter. For that, here from this formula Poisson's ratio, now we calculate the change in length, so that by using this equation we can calculate easily. 0.25 is equals to change in diameter we need to calculate, and diameter of the bar is given 10. Next, change in length is 0.334 and original length of the bar is 350. From this equation, change in diameter by original diameter is equals to 0.25 into 0.334 by 350. Okay. Therefore, the diameter of the bar we know 0.25 into 0.334 by 350. When this diameter it comes to RHS side, it will get multiplied. Diameter of the bar is 10. Therefore, by using this we can calculate the value of change in diameter is 2.387 into 10 power minus 3 millimeters. Here change in length is 0.334 millimeters. Okay. Now calculated change in diameter and change in diameter in the body. Now we need to calculate Now we calculated change in diameter and change in length. Now we need to calculate change in volume. Change in volume. We know the formula change in length by using the relation between E and K. E and K, I am using the relation between E and K. E is equals to 3K into 1 minus 2 by M. In this formula, we know that Poisson's ratio and Young's modulus, by using this, you can calculate it, where K is equals to 3 into 1 minus 2 by M, that equals to Young's modulus is 2 into 10 power 5 by 3 into 1 minus 2 into 1 by M is 0.25. by simplifying this equation, you will get the value of K is 133.33. But K means direct stress by volumetric strain. Therefore, volumetric strain is equals to direct stress by 133.33. Direct stress formula is value is 190.98. Already we calculated by 133.33. By simplifying this, we will get the value of volumetric strain is 1.43235 into 10 power minus 3. Volumetric strain means change in volume by original volume. Therefore, change in volume is equals to 1.43235 into 10 power minus 3 into volume formula pi by 4 d square into L. Length of the bar is 350. Therefore, final value 39.37 millimeter cube. It is the change in volume in the material due to the applied load. Okay, it is the procedure to calculate the change in diameter, change in volume, and change in length whenever a body is submitted to the applied load. Okay.